Hello, today we're going to learn about the Filmetrics F50-UV reflectometer. Step 1, starting the software and the lamps. From the desktop, open the Filmetrics software. The system will then take time to home itself and calibrate. Be sure not to place any objects on top of the system, as the stage will move and will possibly knock them to the ground or damage the stage. After startup, the software will open to the wafer map page, but you can navigate to the measure page. To turn on the lamps, open the UV control software and activate the tungsten lamp, the deuterium lamp, and also open the shutter. If you look behind the computer that powers the system, you can see the corresponding lights turn on the light source. Wait 5 minutes for the lamps to stabilize. Step 2, taking a baseline. From the measure screen, click the baseline button. It will give you the option to take sample reflectance. When you click that, the stage will retract. From the stage controls, move the stage back out towards you and place your sample in the center of the stage. Once loaded, set to 00 to move the sample back to the center. You can use the Z controls to focus manually, but you can also use autofocus, and the system will set the Z value to that of the greatest reflective intensity. Keep in mind that if you use the autofocus for the baseline, you will also need to use it in your recipe. Once focused on your sample, press OK, and the system will measure the reflectance of your sample. After this, the system will take a reflectance standard, typically a silicon wafer that we provide. You will unload your sample, reload the silicon wafer. Once again, you can manually focus or autofocus if you've used autofocus already. Press OK, and the system will measure the reflectance of the silicon standard. It will then navigate to the mirror on the edge of the stage to measure a null signal by reflecting all the light away from it. It does this automatically. Due to the wide variety of samples used with this equipment, the spectrometer peak intensity can change from user to user. Do not be alarmed if you get a message alerting you about that change. Step 3, loading, editing, and running a recipe. After taking your baseline, use the Go To controls on the measure screen to unload the silicon, load your sample, and then locate it on the stage and focus. You can also click on the video output to make small adjustments to location. Once you've found your point of interest, use the drop-down menu, select your recipe, and click Edit to refine it before use. From the recipe editor, you can choose different materials depending on what you're measuring. You can remove or add layers. You can set initial guesses for thickness and the acceptable tolerance. You can change the units displayed. You can change additional settings, choosing to look at a fixed range or all the displayed data available from your scan. For a full explanation of the settings available to you, consult with a staff member or the manual available on the system computer. And remember that if you used autofocus during your baseline, you will need to enable it for your recipe. To save a recipe for reuse, give it a unique name so you'll be sure to find it later. Once your sample is loaded and the recipe is configured, press Measure. The system will then display the measured reflectance as well as a calculated estimate of your film thickness, as well as a goodness of fit. High 90s shows a good confidence that this information is correct. Now, if we remeasure, there is a very slight variation on the scale of angstroms. Note how, as I travel to a location on my sample without a film, the system detects that and tells me that the film is 0 angstroms thick. Step 4, using your data. After measuring your sample, you can use the File menu to save this data either as an image, a measured spectrum, or a plain text file for export to other systems. Additionally, the History tab can be used to look at data from previous scans, although keep in mind this is periodically overwritten, so it's best to save your scans through the File menu if you think that you are going to need them in the future. You can also take previous scans from history, send them back to Measure, and then reanalyze them with a new recipe. Step 5, shutting down the system. Before closing the software, use the Go To button to unload any samples you have on the stage. After removing them, you exit out of the FilMapper software, the same as any other Windows software. Next, deactivate the lamps and close the shutter on the light source. Make sure that the lights on the physical light source have turned off. If you have any questions, please ask a staff member. Thank you for watching.